Potatoes, then you are bastards and not sons. Illegitimate. You are illegitimate and not sons. But if God is doing the disciplining, if God is doing the correcting, then you are what? Sons. Amen? Amen. Praise God. Listen, what the holler about. Knowledge of the scripture is not the key. Obedience is. See? Knowledge of the scripture is not the key to this whole thing. It's all obedience. I read day in and day out. My wife used to say I intimidated her the way I studied. I had all kinds of books all over the bed. I thought I was in the will of God. You know, I'm bringing them down. I'm getting all kinds of revelation. I was so strung out you wouldn't believe it. I had all my books open on one side, and here's a testimony for you, and had my crack on the other. Saying, forgive me, Lord, and getting filled. Getting filled. Then crying about why are you still filling me? So much conviction in my heart. Coming to church sucked up and drawn up. Because I didn't want to miss my covering. I said, I don't care you talking about me. I'll be daggone if I'm going to die out there. I'd rather fall dead in the church under the covering than to fall dead in some crack house. Amen. You crazy. You reading the Bible? Yes. I want to remain covered. Because if I can't bring me out, it will. And I need one day to make me walk in obedience. Amen. Praise God. Truth must be allowed to have its way in our lives if we are going to grow and mature. Truth must be allowed to have its way in our life. I refuse to compromise today. I'm talking about the littlest thing. I'm in a program up there called Teen Challenge, and that's what I work for. And thank God for this church, they sit me there with their long-suffering patience with me. They sit me there, and I decided to get back to that ministry and work for them. I'm going to finish it up shortly. But I will not compromise the rule. Because I realize if I break one rule, I break the bigger one. I mean, whatever the rule says, can you eat a piece of chocolate candy? I refuse to do it. Why? Because God said don't do it. Because if I do it, I'm breaking the small rule. And he can't trust me with nothing greater. Today, that ministry gives me what I call a gratuity every 2 weeks of $100. I tithe that thing. And give an offering on that thing. Amen? And I'm still able to function, come here, what, every 2 weeks on the bus, 2 hours on the bus, back and forth, not one or two times a week, three or four. And I'm like, I used to make $1,200 every 2 weeks in my pocket bulging and be gone in 2 days. Let me pay a tithe. Now I'm tithing every day, still got money coming in and going. Everything is being met off $100. Come on. I'm telling God, I don't know who he is. I went to a meeting once, and we sat in there, and all the brothers was there, and we were all talking, and I said, Bruno, we come here. What is this problem? I asked everybody, and I said, who in this room is tithing? And not one person in the room is tithing. I said, no wonder he curse. No wonder he curse. We ain't got no reason to gripe. I got up, and I said, I ain't going back to no more meetings. They let me leave. That's why I wanted to stay close. But hell, y'all ain't hearing me. Y'all ain't hearing me. Amen. Let's move on. Let's talk this now. What must we do to become stable as sons of God? Amen. What must we become stable to be sons of God? How do we become stable? Let's go to 2 Peter. This is one of my favorite scriptures. I stand on these scriptures. It's a recipe that was taught to me. Amen. I know y'all hear me keep referencing what Dad taught me. Why? I'm in here with what my father taught me. The scriptures out there with the recipes that he's given me for the 8 years I've been here. And I've learned them now and putting them into practice. Amen? I stand on these scriptures. Because they're recipes. If you follow them, you will see each of them will work right into the area that you need to walk with God each and every day. And I plan to keep on doing that. Amen? I wake up with that morning scripture that he taught me. If any of us lack faith, let us ask of God to get to heaven and live up there if not, and share and give him. But let him not waver. Wow, when you got waves like the wave of the sea, you're with the wind and toss. Thank you, Lord. Good morning. Amen. Starting at verse 1. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 1. I'm sorry, 2 Peter chapter 1, starting at verse 3. Forgive me. Can you see my notes? Starting at verse 3. According as the divine power has given unto us all things that pertain to life and godliness, through the knowledge of him that has called us to glory and virtue. Here we go. Y'all ready to hear God? Whereby are given unto us exceedingly great and precious promises, that by these you might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through us. And besides this, Here we go. Giving all diligence unto your faith, virtue, and to your virtue, knowledge, and to your knowledge, temperance, and to your temperance, patience, and to your patience, godliness, and to godliness, brotherly kindness, and more, and to your brotherly kindness, charity, which is love. For if these things be in you and abound, that make you that you shall neither be barren and unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Here we go. But he that lacks these things is blind and cannot see afar off, and has forgotten that he was purged from his own sins. You forgot where you came from. Amen. Here's my favorite scripture right here. Wherefore, because of all that, wherefore, the rather, brother, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if you do these things, you shall never fall. If you do these things, you shall never fall. I'm telling you. Amen. Go over to 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. Check this out. But the God of all grace, who has called us unto eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that you have suffered. Oh my God. After you have, oh man, am I running around this room right now? After you have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish you, strengthen, then he settles you. Hallelujah. Come on. But you gotta suffer. You gotta suffer a little while. But when you rest in him, he'll settle you. See, I've learned that the way to destroy pride is by to get the peace of God in your life. Oh, y'all don't hear me? That's how I found out the recipe. I had to follow this thing and follow this, and I got the peace of God and pride left. Because that's what he don't want you to have, is the peace of God. Keep your mama complaining and worrying about issues that he's already taken care of. Come on, man. Praise God. Let's go. Philippians 4:13. Familiar scripture. I'm almost with you. I'm almost done. Amen. I'm getting excited now. Philippians 4:13.